This is video number 5 out of the series of 8 videos about the blueprint for a successful business makeover, which contains 8 steps that every business owner should know to grow to their full business potential. Chapter number 5 of the blueprint for a successful business makeover. 8 steps which every business owner should know to grow their business to the full business potential. And this is about team. Do you even have team members? Do you employ people? Some people, if they don't employ people, they think, I don't have a team. But I doubt that. You still have people where you negotiate with. You still have people who work for you because you hire them, for example, your bookkeeper. You still have people you talk to and advise you. And how about, are they allowed to make mistakes? And especially when you have team members, are they allowed to make mistakes? Because I know this is a big issue, and I had a big team too. In the peak season, I had 25 people working for me in 3 different countries. No, 4 actually, 4 different countries. So, I know what it's like to manage a team. Are they allowed to make mistakes? Because, you know, in the end, it always costs you money if one of your team members or employees makes a mistake. So how do you cope with that? How do you handle it? And how are you as a manager, the managing business owner? You know, small businesses, usually the business owner is working hands-on in the business too. So he or she is not really a manager. Working and handling the team is one of the tasks which is on his or her plate. It's something completely different than being a manager. And often those are not the things that a business owner is very good at, because they haven't learned. They don't have the natural skills very often. So you have to invest in those skills if you want to have a good team. What are the ingredients of a good team? You need to know. And this is very important. You need to know how to keep the ones which are really good. Because if they are good, usually they get bored very quickly and they need more challenges and more challenges. They need to grow. Otherwise, they will go for another challenge with another company or maybe even with your competition. And that's not what you like. So how do you keep them? And what kind of agreements do you make with them? How do they interact with each other? How do they interact with you? Do you have a code of honor? How people treat each other in your company? Or if you don't have a company, how do you want to treat the people who advise you? Or where you outsource stuff to? And then how do you build a great team? You have to have a code of honor, but that's not all. They have to do something out of the normal routine. And what do you do? And how do you do this? And then there's this flexible group of people who belong to your team too. Nowadays, you can have a big company and don't employ anybody. But how do you do this? And you have to, then you will work with flexible staff. And I will explain to you exactly all the various possibilities. So this was video number 5 out of the range, the blueprint for a successful business makeover. 8 steps that every business owner should know to grow to the full business potential. And this was video number 5 from the series, the blueprint for a successful business makeover. 8 steps that every business owner should know to grow to your full business potential.